Hi, this is Simon from CodeTwo. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the HTML editor and CodeTwo exchange rules to create email signatures for your company. I'm also going to show you how to insert the signatures directly under latest replies and forwards in email conversations. Okay, I already have CodeTwo exchange rules running on my computer. To access the HTML editor, I just have to press the edit button right here. And I'm in. As you can see, the layout of the editor resembles Microsoft Office applications. The three buttons at the top allow me to switch between the three available formats of templates. The reason why I want to set up all three is because some messages are still sent in RDF or plain text, and I don't want them slipping through without a signature. But right now I'll do the HTML version only. Just like in Microsoft Word, all the editing work is done in this section. These grayed out boxes over here represent consecutive emails in a conversation. The white box is, of course, the signature block. And this is where I'm going to design the template. It will be pretty simple. I'm going to go ahead and start with a two-cell table with invisible borders. In the left cell, I'm going to go ahead and put a logo. To do this, I just need to click Picture. And now I can select a local picture or a web picture. I always select a local picture because then this image is added as an inline image to all messages. So it means that it will become a part of the message and it will not be displayed as an attachment. If you select a web picture, your recipients might have a hard time opening or viewing these images because they might be blocked by their email client, or these users might have to click a special download pictures button to download these images from the internet. So a local picture is better. While providing a path to this local image, you have to make sure that this is not located on a shared or mapped disk. You can also turn it into a hyperlink if you want. And then just click OK. Now the Active Directory fields. First name. Last name. What else do we need? Department. Company. Mobile phone number. And landline number. These placeholders will be turned into Active Directory information. So, for instance, first name and last name will be turned into John Doe, depending on the person who is sending the message. The same goes for department, company, and this person's mobile and landline phone numbers. What if some users don't have one of these numbers provided in Active Directory? Not a problem at all. This is what the Remove Text Stack button is for. I just highlight a line and click the RT button. Having done this, when CodeTwo Exchange Rules updates the fields with Active Directory information and doesn't find any data, it will remove the whole line from a given user's signature. And if it does find the data, the line will be left intact. Okay, now just some final touches. Let's change the font and its size. You can also change the color if you want. And finally, I can decide where the content will be positioned in the table. To do this, I have to highlight the text and then choose one of these options. I think I'll align it to the left and vertically to the center. Okay. I think it looks nice right now, so I can save it. The program now informs me that the RDF and plain text formats aren't configured yet. I can go back and design the two remaining formats from scratch or use the convert option. This is all in terms of the email signature template design. One last setting available in the template editor is the email layout. You may have noticed the box over here. In it, I can add and remove various segments that CodeTwo Exchange Rules will insert into the email. Right now, I only have the signature, but I can easily add side banners and a header. And by clicking these arrows, adjust their positioning. Additionally, I can decide whether the signature should be inserted at the very bottom of the email conversation or beneath the latest reply or forward. To do this, I can use the switch over here. Or click this gear icon and choose the option I want. As you can see, every change I make in the setting is reflected in the editor. I can also decide what the program should do when the signature is already found in a conversation. The results of this setting will be visible once user starts exchanging emails. Save the most recent changes. And that's all there is to it. Thanks for watching.